Carolina, and it is Christmas Eve here in Raleigh, North Carolina, and we are coming your way this evening to celebrate the birth of Christ, his death on the cross, and mighty resurrection, and all that Christ represents in our lives. So I welcome you to this service. I welcome those watching online on Facebook, on YouTube, on Vimeo, and on our website. You are all welcome in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Welcome those on site. You're all welcome in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's be on our feet and begin to appreciate God tonight and give him all the praise and honor due to his holy name. He deserves our worship. He deserves all the praise. He deserves all the praise. Let's thank him. Let's thank him. Let's worship him for bringing us into his banqueting hall tonight to bless us as only he can. The Bible says that blessed is he that he has chosen and he has caused to approach his courts, for he shall be satisfied with the goodness of his house. I appreciate him tonight. Give him all the praise and glory. He is worthy of our praise. He is worthy of our praise. Appreciate him. Worship Jesus, the Son of the living God, who came, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, and on the third day he was crucified, and on the third day he rose again, according to scriptures, for our justification. Give him the praise and honor due to his name. We can't thank him enough. We can't thank him enough for what he has done. He left his heavenly estate, took upon the nature of man to die for you and to die for me. What a privilege, what an honor that God should come down to my level. He's touched by the feelings of our infirmities. He feels what you feel. He passed through the same temptations that you are passing through today. And that's why we can cry unto him for help, and he will always be there to help us. Lift up your hands again and appreciate him this evening. Give him all the praise. Give him all the honor. The Bible made us to understand that his name shall be called Jesus, for he shall be our Savior, for he shall save his people from their sins. And the Bible also said his name shall be called Emmanuel, God with us. He is ever with us. Give him all the praise this evening, for he is our Savior. Appreciate him because he is our deliverer. Appreciate him because he is our righteousness. Appreciate it because he is God with us. God Emmanuel. God with us. His name is Emmanuel. Appreciate him because he is our righteousness. He is our deliverer. He is our stronghold. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runs into him and he is saved. Appreciate him. Give him all the praise. He deserves our worship. He deserves our worship. He deserves our worship. Give him praise. Give him praise. He has done all things well. He has done all things well by coming to be born of a Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, and on the third day he rose again, and he ascended up on high. And we have the Holy Spirit here with us. We have the Spirit of Christ. And he has opened unto us the gates of heaven.
Thank you, Jesus.
So we cannot cry our Father. Because we are now seated with him in the heavenly places, far above all principalities and powers. Give him all the praise.
Thank you,
he deserves our praise and worship.
Thank you,
give him
Jesus.
Praise. Give him all the honor. He is worthy of our praise.
Thank you.
He is worthy of our praise.
You're worthy.
Worship him. Worship him tonight. Give him praise.
We'll give you praise.
Give him adoration. What a mighty God we serve.
Thank you.
What a mighty God we serve. Father, we give you praise.
Thank you.
Blessed be your holy name.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be your holy name.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be your holy name, Father.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Father, we thank you.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
We give you all the praise. We give you all the honor.
Thank you, Jesus.
On this Christmas Eve, we celebrate with Christians all over the world the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Thank you for sending your son Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Lord.
You demonstrated your love by sending him to die for us.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
The Bible made us understand that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall believe in him will not perish, but have everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you, Father, because in him we have everlasting life.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Father, because by reason of his death, his mighty resurrection and ascension, we are now part of the family of God.
Amen.
Blessed be your name, Father.
Hallelujah.
We welcome you, sweet Spirit of God, in this service.
Holy Spirit,
you have your way.
Have your
in
way,
everything
God.
We are going to do.
Have your
Let
way.
Your name be glorified.
Amen.
In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen.
You are all welcome.
Amen.
Enjoy the rest of the service.
Amen.
In Jesus' precious name.
Amen. Amen.
That is
my covenant identity.
In this Christmas Eve service, we'll continue by reading some Isaiah chapter 9, verse 1 to 8. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 1 to 8 says, "Nevertheless, the dimension shall not be such as was in her vexation, when at the first he lightly afflicted the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali, and afterward did more grievously afflict her by the way of the sea, beyond Jordan in Galilee of the nations." Amen.
Amen.
Verse 2, "The people that walk in the darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them the light shine. Thou hast multiplied the nations and not increased the joy. They joy before thee according to the joy in the harvest, and as men rejoice when they divide the spoil. For thou hast broken the yoke of his burden and the staff of his shoulder, the rod of his oppressor, as in the day of Midian. For every battle of the warrior is with confused noise, and garments rolled in blood, but this shall be with burning and feel of fire. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end, upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. The Lord sent a word into Jacob, and it had lighted upon Israel." Amen.
Amen.
This is the word of the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen. As we proceed in this service, we are going to welcome the beautified seeds for their Christmas carol. Amen. Let's your hands up together for Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Feliz Navidad, Prospera y Felicidad. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad, Prospera y Felicidad. Feliz Navidad.
Woo! Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Out of the mouths of babes and sucklings, God has ordained strength.
Amen.
To that he might stay the adventure. What a joy to hear the beautified seeds. Render those beautiful tunes to the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Merry Christmas to everyone watching.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to everyone on site. What a joy to commemorate the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And Jesus came to save us. He came so that we can become part and parcel of the family of God.
Amen.
What a privilege.
Amen.
So we can now cry, Abba Father.
Yes, Lord.
We enjoy the same privileges, the same rights, the same duties that Christ has as the Son of God.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In this great month of December, our prophetic focus is my great preparation precedes my great performance. Can we say that together?
My great preparation precedes my great performance.
So that has been our prophetic focus for this great month of December, preparing ourselves for our emergence in the new year. I see you emerging in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I see you becoming great. And
amen.
I see a great destiny manifesting in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Nothing will stop you from imagining.
Amen.
Nothing will stop you from manifesting
amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And in our Thursday meetings since the month, we've been looking at the exhortation line, the impediments to great preparations. Can we say that together?
Impediments
to great preparations. When we talk about impediments, we are talking about roadblocks. We are talking about hindrances that can stop you from preparing greatly. And we started from the onset that the objectives of this topic is number one, to expose both the recognizable and unrecognizable roadblocks or impediments to great preparations. Number two, objective, to know how to deal decisively with these roadblocks or impediments. And number three, to begin to take preparatory steps toward a great future. So it's not enough to prepare. While you prepare, there's also the need to take action to execute. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And we began week one, we looked at two impediments. We said the two impediments are no goal or vision. When you don't have a goal or vision, then it can be an impediment to your preparation. We also said that when you are distraction is an impediment to great preparation. And with two, we looked at excuses and procrastination as impediments to great preparation. And last week we looked at assumptions and presumptions, and we also looked at wrong beliefs or wrong mentality as impediments to great preparations. So today we shall be running off this topic, and I trust God that you'll be blessed mightily, and that you begin to take action, begin to prepare for the great things the Lord has in store for us in the coming year and beyond, in the mighty name of Jesus. So today, we are looking at two more impediments to great preparations. Number one, and that should be number seven, based in Siriatim, number seven. Fear of the unknown and losses. Fear of the unknown and losses. When you are afraid of the unknown, when you are afraid of making losses, you feel that if you take this action, it can lead to a loss. When you have not even tried, it can be an impediment to great preparations. Let's look at Proverbs chapter 22 and verse 13. Proverbs chapter 22 and verse 13. And please help me and get Proverbs 12:25 from the Passion Translation. Proverbs 12:25 from the Passion Translation. But I'm going to read Proverbs 22:13. I'm going to read from the King James Version. Proverbs 22 and verse 13. It says, "The slothful man saith, there is a lion without. I shall be slain in the streets. The lazy man claims, there is a lion out there. If I go outside, I might be killed." Praise God. The lazy man is in the house, and he has already concluded out of fear that if I go out, if I take this step, that I may be consumed. The lazy man said, if I venture, I may be eaten up by the lions. Competition is fierce. There's no need to prepare. There's nothing to do. Why would I go out there when the lions have taken over the entire space? The slothful man, that's the lazy man, is full of fear. He doesn't want to venture, he doesn't want to go out by reason of fear. So if I go out there, I will be consumed by a lion on the street. So there are so many of us like that. You know, we are afraid of taking steps. We are afraid of taking steps. We feel that there are stronger people out there. We feel that there are stronger businessmen who have taken over our industry, so to speak. And because of that, you're afraid. You're afraid of taking steps. When the Lord is nudging you in your heart to take step in that direction, that is the lazy man. Before we read Proverbs 12:25, I want us to read Luke chapter 19 and verse 21. Who saw a man gifted by God, but he was afraid to venture. Luke chapter 19 and verse 21. Here's the parable of the miners. One, you know, we're talking about, you know, 10 gifts. They were all given one pound. And the one was given five pounds, another one was given two. Then the one that was given one came and said in verse 21, For I feared thee, because thou art an austere man. But I feared thee. That was why, in verse 20, the Bible says that another came saying, Lord, behold, here is thy pound, which I have kept laid up in a napkin. He did nothing with his own gift. He went and hid his own gift in a napkin. The Matthew's account says that he went and he hid the gift. Why? Because he was afraid. He was afraid. So fear can be an impediment to preparation. Because you are afraid of failing, because you're afraid of the personalities involved, because you're afraid of non-existent things, because you're afraid of the economy going south, because you're afraid of the things the world are afraid of. And that could lead to an impediment. That could lead to, you know, to doing into a situation of doing nothing. It can lead to indolence, spiritual indolence. It can lead to mental indolence. It can lead to lack of preparation. Let's read Proverbs 12 and verse 25 from the Passion Translation.
Proverbs 12:25. TPT. Anxious fear brings depression.
Anxious fear brings depression.
But a life-giving word of encouragement can do wonders to restore joy to the heart.
You know, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
See, anxious fear brings depression. And when you are depressed, you can't do much. You can't even do anything because your spirit is down. Anxious fear brings depression. And when you are depressed, your brain cannot function. Your mind cannot perform at its optimal. You are depressed because you are afraid. That will not be our portion in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said that will not be our portion in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So we need to be careful. I've also come to discover that most times, people are not afraid of change. You know, we talk about change, but actually people are not afraid of change. But what people, because if I ask any person, maybe a poor person, if I ask a poor person, you know, he wants to change and become rich. The poor man wants to be transformed. Maybe if your business is at level one, and I ask you, do you want to scale to level two? You tell me yes, you want to scale to level two. So everybody wants a change, but most times, why we are afraid is not because of the change. We are afraid of the things we think that we'll lose. Maybe lose money, because we don't want to invest money that will lead to the change. Maybe you're afraid of losing relationships. Maybe there are some people that you need to lay off. There are some new people you need to hire. You know, maybe there are some people that you don't want to offend. But this change will necessitate, you know, offending them, kind of, you know, so to speak. But because you are afraid of those losses. You're afraid of maybe turning the table or maybe offending someone. You find out that you become afraid to those changes. And when you're afraid, you can't do much. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It was Gary Hogan who said that fear is the silent destroyer of dreams. Fear is the silent destroyer of dreams. That's why St. Paul writing to his timid protege and son in the Lord, Timothy, in 2 Timothy chapter 1, I think verse 7, he said, "For God has not given us the spirit of fear, but he has given us the spirit of love, power, and of a sound mind." So we need to deal with the spirit of fear, because fear is the destroyer, the silent destroyer of dreams. Amen. Fear will not destroy a dream.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Fear is the fundamental challenge to your dreams and visions. So we need to deal with fear if we must prepare for the great things that God has in store for us. Then fear must be dealt with surgically.
Mm.
Surgically. You know. Why should I believe that fear could be psychological? But fear is mostly spiritual. Fear is mostly spiritual. And you have to deal with it using the Word of God. Asking the Holy Spirit to help you, and you take authority over the foul spirit of fear.
Mm.
Deal with it spiritually. And psychologically, how do you deal with fear? You deal with it by developing your mind. Developing your mind. Because knowledge, when you have knowledge, you'll be confident. You have courage. Even though that you may have issues, you may also sometimes feel like not venturing. But if you have knowledge, you can even have the confidence to venture. And I see you venturing.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every form of fear in your life is destroyed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said every form of fear in your life is destroyed.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So fear is the fundamental challenge to your dream and visions.
Amen.
And we have to deal with it decisively.
Praise
we have
God.
To deal with the spirit of fear decisively.
Praise
the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I say praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I say praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Are you blessed?
Oh yes.
Amen.
Amen.
So I want you to know that note that nothing undermines the power and blessing of a gifted, talented, equipped, and promising leader like fear.
Mm.
According to Gary Hogan, he said nothing determines the power and blessing of a gifted, talented, equipped, and promising leader like fear. He also said that it is the everyday insecurities that lead us to abandon our dreams without even putting up a fight. Because of insecurities, we think that we are not capable, we think that we cannot make it. We feel threatened by competition. We feel threatened by the things we see around us. So it becomes imperative that we fortify ourselves with the Spirit of God.
Amen.
And give attention to God's word and take and build our faith in Him so that we can deal with every form of fear.
Amen.
Decisively.
Amen.
He also said that no great dream of love has been built on the fear of what might go wrong. Sometimes we are afraid of non-existent things. We are afraid that things may go wrong. Or we are afraid that if we invest this money in this business, that things may go wrong. We are afraid of venturing into the future, thinking that, things may go wrong. But he said that it is on the hope of what might go right. So your hope must be intact, and that hope must be a lively hope that is anchored on the word of God.
Yeah.
And that is where faith comes in. Yeah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So we need to deal with the fear of the unknown and losses. So number eight impediment is ease of comfort. Ease of comfort. Every one of us, you know, likes comfort. Not just like, we love comfort. We want to be comfortable. You know, I have in my note here that comfort makes you to conform to existing protocols. You feel comfortable based on existing protocol. I remember, you know, when we were, you know, in politics and, you know, you go for political gatherings and, you know, when someone wants to speak, he said, I will stand on existing protocol. Very confident to stand on existing protocol because he or she doesn't want to take the pains to recognize all the people, all the important people there. So that is comfort makes you to conform to existing protocols. Hear this, your greatness is on the other side of discomfort. Your greatness is on the other side of discomfort. And I've come to discover that why, you know, that the reason why Jesus said I was going to send you another comforter, he had to send the Holy Spirit to come as a comforter. And I was the Holy Ghost ministered to me that why the Holy Ghost had to come as a comforter is because God knows that the journey to destiny is paved with disruptions and discomfort. The journey to your place in destiny is paved. The road is paved with disruptions and discomfort. You know, so that I was telling my wife that life is not straight. It's not a straight life. Life is not straight. So you need the Holy Spirit that can draw a straight line with a crooked stick. So it's not straight. Neither is it a linear graph. We need to come out of our comfort zone if we must be prepared for greatness. Let's begin to look at our scriptures. Let's look at Deuteronomy chapter 2. Deuteronomy chapter 2, we read verses 3, 7, and 14.
Say it again.
Deuteronomy 2. We're talking about ease of comfort. Comfort has destroyed many destinies, and it will not destroy your own life. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Deuteronomy chapter 2 and verse 3 says, ye have compassed this mountain long enough. You have compassed this mountain long enough. Turn you northward. They have become so comfortable. They have acclimatized to the mountains, the base of the mountain, that they did not want to make another move. God was taking them to the promised land, the land flowing with milk and honey, but they came to the mountain and relaxed. They came to the mountain and relaxed. You know, it happens, you know, just like the children of the Reubenites and the children of God, when they came to and I think it was Gilead that they saw the verdant pasture, and said, "Oh, this place is good for our livestock. Let us stay here." You know, why the other tribe, you know, move over Jordan, you know, to possess the land. And they even volunteered to go and fight with their brethren, and then come back to that place because they felt that that was the best for them. They felt comfortable there. But when God has prepared something better in front, the Bible says, "You have compassed this mountain long enough. Turn you not toward." Tell your neighbor, "Turn not toward." That's verse 3. Verse 7 says, "For the Lord thy God has blessed thee in all the works of thy hand. He knoweth thy walking through this great wilderness. These 40 days the Lord thy God hath been with thee, thou hast lacked nothing." Because they lacked nothing there, they felt that was the place to be. They felt manna was the highest. That's why you find out that in socialist countries, you know, people remain poor because everybody is dependent on handouts. Everyone is dependent on handouts. So let's look at verse 14 of that same Bible passage. Verse 14 says, "And the space in which we came from Kadesh Barnea until we were come over to the brook Zered was 38 years, until all the generation of the men of war were wasted out from among the host, as the Lord swore unto them." Praise God. I say, praise God.
Hallelujah.
Let's look at verse 24. We have seen how they were comfortable where they were. Now look at the instruction of God to his people. Verse 24 says, "Rise ye up, take up your journey, and pass over the river Arnon. Behold, I have given into thy hand Sihon the Amorite, king of Heshbon, and his land." What did he say? "Begin to possess it and contend with him in battle." So most times, because we don't want the discomfort of possessing and the discomfort of contending, no, we don't want to fight. So because we don't want to fight, we take our flight. We fly away from the fight and rest in our comfort zone. Hear this, if you don't fight, you will not obtain your inheritance. He said, "Fight the good fight of faith and lay hold on eternal life." So until you fight, you don't lay hold on your inheritance. He said, "Rise up now, take up your journey, because you have a journey of destiny to make, and pass over the river Arnon. Behold, I have given into thy hand Sihon the Amorite, king of Heshbon, and his land. Begin to possess it." Begin to possess it. You need to start. You need to take action and contend with him in battle. The good news is that you have already won. But you have to contend.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So, we need to contend in battle. And in Amos chapter 6 and verse 1, the Bible says, "That woe unto them that are at ease in Zion." Woe unto them that are at ease in Zion. Tonight, I want to encourage us, even as we celebrate Christmas, to shun by the Spirit every form of comfort. Jesus came. He didn't come in a comfort manner. He came and was discomforted by being born in a manger. He was being born in a manger, and he from manger he became a manager. A manager of resources, a manager of men, and a manager of all the inheritance, all that God has. Because he had to, he did not shy away from the discomfort that was associated with his ministry. So don't shy away from the discomfort that comes with greatness, because that is the only way you can possess your possession.
Amen.
And thank God for the Holy Spirit, who is our comforter. He will see us through all the way. That's why David said in the 23rd Psalm that even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, that I will fear no evil. Why? Because thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That's Psalm 23 and verse 4. Because it's because of divine presence.
Mm-hmm.
God will always comfort us no matter what we're going through. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I said, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So, tonight, we're going to pray. Jesus came and he died to deal with he that has the power of death. So that you will no longer fear. He came to destroy fear.
Yeah.
So tonight, every form of fear in your life will be destroyed, will be dealt with by the Spirit.
Amen.
And God will empower you to begin to do exploits in his name.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Have you been blessed?
Oh, yes.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Before we pray in this service, and you are in this service and you are not born again, what a day to give your life to Christ. In some jurisdictions, they have already gone into Christmas Day. And here in America, where this is Christmas Eve, what a day to give your life to Christ. If you are in this service and you are not born again, this is the time for you to surrender your life to Christ and allow him to be your Lord and Savior. Are you here? You have not given your life to Christ, or you have vaccinated. You have the opportunity to give your life to him right now.
Amen.
So if you want to come to Jesus tonight, if you want to show him that you appreciate his coming to this world, to die for our sins, and we appreciate what he did on the cross of Calvary.
Amen.
And you appreciate his mighty resurrection and
Amen.
Ascension. Please put your right hand on your chest and say this prayer after me. Father, in the name of Jesus,
I
thank you for your son Jesus.
I thank you for your son Jesus.
Who came in the form of man.
Died for my sins.
Died for my sins. And rose again on the third day.
And rose again on the third day.
For my justification.
For my justification.
I receive him today.
I receive him today.
Into my life.
Into my life.
As my Lord and my Savior.
As my Lord and my Savior.
I renounce every form of wickedness.
I renounce every form of wickedness.
I renounce every form of evil.
I renounce every form of evil.
And I receive your Spirit today.
And I receive your Spirit today.
The Spirit of righteousness.
The Spirit of righteousness.
The Spirit of grace.
The Spirit of grace.
The Spirit of sanctification.
The Spirit of sanctification.
And I begin to walk in newness of life.
And I begin to walk in newness of life.
Because he that is born of God.
Because he that is born of God.
Has overcome the world.
Has overcome the world.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
In Jesus' precious name. We have prayed.
Amen.
Father, thank you for these precious ones. I'm praying for you. We receive them into your kingdom.
Amen.
And we decree and declare that none of these ones shall be found wanting in that day of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you.
Equip them with everything good for doing your will.
Amen.
Walk in them, Lord, that which is well pleasing in your sight. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I say praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I say praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Congratulations. If you gave your life to Christ, we rejoice with you. This is the best decision ever. And we want to encourage you to find a Bible-believing church near you that, or wherever the Lord will lead you to be part of that assembly prayerfully do that. And we also run a global church. And if the Lord is laying your heart to be part of this ministry, Beautify Sense Church, please go to our website, beautifysense.com, fill the membership form, or if you want to be a partner, fill the partnership form or associate form as the Lord leads you, and we'll reach out to you, and we want to be part of your progress. And if you have to give your life to Christ, please make sure you send an email to us or a direct message and notify us of what the Lord has done for you, so that we can rejoice with you and keep praying for you, that you will be established in the faith, and so that Christ will be fully formed in you, in Jesus' precious name.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Today is Christmas Eve service. We're going to wrap up this service with the Holy Communion. We're going to appreciate God by the mystery of the Holy Communion. And just like we were taught in the exaltation tonight, that we need to deal with fear. We need to deal with fear. And part of what Jesus came to do is to deal with fear. Look at Hebrews chapter 2 and verse 14. Hebrews chapter 2 and verse 14 says, "For as much then as the children are partakers of flesh and blood, he also himself likewise took part of the same, that through death he might destroy him that had the power of death, that is the devil." Okay. He came to deliver us from fear. He came to deliver us from fear, that he might destroy the power of death. You know, many believers, some people are afraid. And part of what Jesus came to do is to deliver us from fear, every form of fear. And the Bible says, perfect love cast out all fears. And Jesus Christ is love personified. And we are partaking of the flesh and the blood of Christ. So when you partake of the flesh and of the blood, you have to receive that flesh. Like if you read verse 15, it says, "And deliver them who through fear of death were all their lifetime subject to bondage."
Amen.
Who through fear? Fear keeps you in perpetual bondage. And that's what Jesus came to help us to overcome. And the Bible says that whatever that is born of God overcomes the world. Fear inclusive.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And what a joy. The Spirit of Christ is in us to also make us comfortable in the midst of discomfort and disruptions.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. So as we partake of the flesh and the blood of Christ tonight, I want you to lay hold on what Christ has already done for you, and deal with every form of fear, and deal with every form of lousiness or laziness or staying at ease in Zion.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Father, we have come to your communion table tonight in deep humility, in total reverence. And as we remember your first coming, we are also preparing ourselves for your second coming. And between now and your second coming, Lord, you told us to commemorate this Eucharist, this unbreak bread, even as we remember your death and your mighty resurrection. And you said that we will not eat of this communion again until that marriage feast of the Lamb. Lord, as we who are here, who are led by your Spirit, who are your sons and daughters, partake of this, of your flesh and blood, we ask, O God, that you deal decisively, you deal surgically with every form of fear in our lives, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray that you empower us, O God, by your Spirit, to go through the disruptions and the discomforts of destiny, so that we can emerge winners, we can emerge as great men. We can come out on the other side as the perfect and mature men and women that you have made us to be, and so that we will obtain our glorious inheritance. Father, we ask, O God, that if there perhaps there's anyone amongst us who is sick in the body, who need healing, let healing take place as we partake of your flesh and blood. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
If you're watching online, please bring out your own. I hope you have your own communion elements and join us as we celebrate this communion. And in the name of God the Father, God the Son, we consecrate these elements. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, we consecrate these elements, both the one here and the one being used by our brethren online, wherever you are, the same power comes upon it, and we declare those elements, the body and the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you.
We say with joy and thanksgiving, in Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
Amen. Let's receive the body of Christ and his blood Amen. With thanksgiving.
Amen.
Let's begin to appreciate him, give him praise,
thank you,
worship him tonight.
Thank you.
Father, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
We thank you.
Thank
begin
you.
To enforce your blessings, begin to enforce your deliverance.
Thank you, Lord.
Begin to enforce your deliverance. We say no to fear.
Maka
dalaba, lima mama sundalaba ba. Mala mama sundalaba, likalaba mama mama. I am no longer a slave to sin. I am no longer a slave to fear. In the name of Jesus, I've been delivered from fear. In the name of Jesus, I have the fortitude, I have the courage
Amen.
To go through the disruptions and discomforts of life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you. I receive freshness, Lord.
Amen.
I receive your multiplied grace.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, I'm walking in power. I'm walking in wisdom.
Amen.
Oh, thank you for your righteousness, Lord. Thank you because I am your righteousness, Lord, in Christ Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus. Thank you, thank you,
thank you.
Blessed be you, and I have the mind of Christ.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, thank you because my health is fully restored.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
No weapon fashioned against me prospers.
Amen.
Every tongue that has risen up against me in judgment is condemned right now.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus, you came to save us.
Yes,
and thank you because I'm saved, I'm delivered, I'm whole.
Amen.
Thank you because I'm free.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Spirit of Christ,
Amen.
Because you're here with us.
Amen.
We thank you for the great work you're doing in Amen. And through us.
Amen.
We give you all the praise and glory.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name.
Hallelujah.
For in Jesus' precious name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Put your hands together for the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Were you blessed by that word?
Oh, yes.
Amen.
Thank
Praise
you,
the Lord.
Jesus.
It's offering time. For this Christmas Eve service, please, let's package our offering. Let's package our tithes. Worship God with our substance. The Bible says we should honor him. The wise men came to see the newborn king with their hands and pockets fully loaded. They came with gifts. You don't come to greatness empty-handed. They came with gifts. And they gave gifts to the newborn king. Say, where is he that is born king of the Jew? For we have seen his star in the east, and we have come to worship him. So the part of their worship was their gift. So tonight, package your gift in terms of monetary or treasures, just like the wise men, because wise men always come to greatness with gifts. Also, package your tithes and any other kingdom seed that you have come to worship God with, and do that. Also, if you are using the e-payment platforms, we can use Zelle, beautifysense@gmail.com. I think it's already on the screen, pinned on the screen. Hallelujah. So please do so, and the God of heaven will bless you mightily in Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
Let's pray. Father, Thank you, Father, for the privilege to give unto you. We have come with our gifts to worship you.
Amen.
Receive our worship.
Amen.
Bless our offerings. Bless our tithes.
Amen.
Increase the fruits of our righteousness.
Amen.
And let your name alone be glorified.
Amen.
In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed.
Amen.
In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. While you are giving your offerings and tithes, please listen to the flowing announcements. We want to appreciate everyone that joined us in this Christmas Eve service. We thank our beautified seeds for that beautiful rendition. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Tomorrow is Christmas Day, so we encourage you to enjoy with family and friends, and please let us not go on spiritual vacation.
Amen.
It's not a time to go wild or to engage in riotous living. But it's a time of sober reflection. It's a time for us to really appreciate God for what he has done for us and begin to walk in newness of life.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
While we're celebrating, let us also remember those who do not have and extend that same love of Christ to them by offering them something to eat and drink.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As you do so, the God of heaven will continually bless you in Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
This is Beautify Saints Church. For those who are worshiping with us for the very first time, we are commissioned by God to raise a tribe of Beautify Saints through the prophetic word of grace. Please feel free to go to our website, beautifysaints.com, to get more information about us, what we believe in, our tenets of faith, and know more about the ministry.
Amen.
If you also need any other information, feel free to send us an email, info@beautifysaints.com. We'll be glad to respond. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What a joy. There shall be no service tomorrow, but we're here on Sunday for our end of year Thanksgiving.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What a joy. We are coming to the end of the year 2020. So next Sunday will be the last Sunday of the year, and that will be our end of year Thanksgiving service. Please come gaily dressed, come prepared, come with your Thanksgiving offering, and God of heaven will bless you mightily in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As we thank him, he qualifies us for the new year, for the blessings of the new year.
Amen.
You know, things will open up for us.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
It's part of our preparation. Please prepare your offerings before coming to church. You know, do it intentionally, meditatively, and with the help of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And God will accept your offerings in Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
In Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
Next week, Thursday, is our crossover service, our New Year Eve service. We shall communicate to you the time. I think we'll start earlier than normal. We'll start at 5 p.m. Eastern, which will be 11 p.m. West African time.
Mm-hmm.
For the interest of those our members in West Africa to be able to join us and as they cross over the New Year. So next week Thursday, we're having a New Year Eve service. And it's going to be a powerful time. God will be speaking to us, his mind concerning this house for the year 2021.
Amen.
I see you already in the year 2021.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That there shall be no carryover.
Amen.
In your life, in your business,
Amen.
In your relationships, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Bible says, surely there is an end.
Oh, yes.
And thy expectation shall not be cut off. Your expectation in this year shall not be cut off.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And now unto him that is able to keep you from falling, to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, is the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, honor, power, majesty, dominion, authority, splendor, both now and forevermore.
Amen.
Amen. Remain ever beautified.
Amen.
And see you on Sunday.
Amen.
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 God bless you.
Bless you too.